Dear students, in the previous video we did this problem, and here the sin square omega t was written as 1 by 2 minus 1 by 2 cos 2 omega t. Simple harmonic motion definition 1, if the displacement of the projection point is denoted by a cos omega t plus pi, then you can say it is executing simple harmonic motion. Now you compare, see here, the displacement must be either a cos omega t plus pi, or on y axis the displacement be a sin omega t plus pi at time t, or it can be linear combination of cos and sin functions as a cos omega t plus b sin omega t. When the displacement is expressible in these forms, now you can say the projection point is executing simple harmonic motion. Now see, in this problem, this function is written as like this, and here let us check here. See, this resembles this cos omega t plus a cos omega t plus pi. A is amplitude, here amplitude is 1 by 2, so in place of omega t here 2 omega t came. In place of pi there is nothing, means you can write 0. So this is resembling with this. So this part, you can say, looking at this part, you can say the given function represents simple harmonic motion. But you get one doubt here, 1 by 2, a constant is coming. What about this constant? This equation can be written as 0 plus a cos omega t plus pi. And this function tells you that the projection point is executing to and fro motion about origin or about a mean position. The mean position was taken at origin. So this 0 tells you that this is executing. See, up to right hand side it is going up to plus a, and on left hand side it is going up to minus a. So between these two limits the projection point is moving to and fro, making simple harmonic motion, and this 0 stands for its mean position. Now comparing this with this, in place of 0 you got 1 by 2. It means here the projection point is executing simple harmonic motion not about origin but about 1 by 2. Suppose we draw a graph like this. Suppose this is origin, this is x axis and this is y axis. Say this is 1 by 2, this is 1, this is 3 by 2, like this. So the projection point is here, and this is the mean position, and from this mean position it is moving to right hand side and to left hand side. So this is in the projection point is making to and fro motion about 1 by 2. If it is expressible like this, it is making to and fro motion about origin. And here in our problem this function tells you that this is executing, its projection point is executing simple harmonic motion about 1 by 2, like that's all. Now let us look at example 8.4. Figure below depicts two circular motions. The radius of the circle, the period of revolution, the initial position and the sense of revolution are indicated in the figures. Obtain the simple harmonic motions of the x projection of the radius vector of the rotating particle P in each case. So this is case A, this is case B. So for this we have to write equation for its displacement of the projection point. Okay, now let us take down this diagram. See, the particle is making circular motion with angular speed omega. See, angular speed omega means, angular speed means angle made by the particle in 1 second. So in 1 second it makes angle of pi radians. In t seconds, how much angle is made by that? So t by 1 into omega, so it makes omega t angle. So here the particle in time t, suppose this comes from here to here, pt is equal to t. It took t seconds of time to move from here to here, say. In t seconds, the angle made by the particle will be omega t. Now, so in the textbook, time period is given, this diagram is given. In the diagram, position of the particle at t is equal to 0 is given. Phase angle at t is equal to 0 is called initial phase. So this is initial phase, and initial phase is represented by pi. So pi is equal to 45 degrees, or in radians it is pi by 4. And now the particle is here initially, and after t seconds it will be here, because it is moving on the circle with angular speed omega. So in 1 second it moves through an angle omega, and in t seconds it moves through an angle t by 1 into omega, that is omega t. Therefore here the angle moved will be omega t. Now see, after t seconds the particle is here, and its projection point is here, and the distance of the projection point from origin is represented by x of t. Now see, OPN is right angle triangle, so is a right angled triangle. In this, here the angle is here to here omega, here to here 45. So in this triangle, this angle is omega t plus pi by 4. This is O N P. So let me write cos of omega t plus pi by 4 is equal to adjacent side by hypotenuse. This adjacent side ON is XT, and OP is radius of the circle, and that is taken as A. So by cross multiplying we get x of t is equal to A cos omega t plus pi by 4. So here capital T 4 seconds, this is not included, this is time period. Now let us take this omega. Omega means angular speed, and it is defined as delta theta by delta t, angular displacement by time. Now if you consider the particle completing one revolution, the particle in, see, actual See, if the particle is completing one revolution, how much time is taken? Capital T. Capital T means period. Period means time taken for one revolution is called time period. So here, for in one revolution, time taken for the particle to complete one revolution. Then, if the particle completes one revolution, what is the angle described by the particle? The particle makes an angle of 360 degrees in one revolution. 360 degrees means 2π radians. So in this way, we write omega is equal to 2π by T. And here time period is given. So this also can be written as pi by 2. Now in place of omega, let us substitute this. A cos 2π/4 T plus π/4. So this is the answer. Now let us look at 8.4b. So if you look at the diagram, the particle at t is equal to 0 is here. So what is the phase angle made by this particle? We measure angle always from positive x-axis. So here the phase angle made at t is equal to 0 is called initial phase. That is called initial phase. Phase at t is equal to 0 is called initial phase, and initial phase is represented by pi, and see that is 90 degrees or pi by 2 radians. Now see, in this figure the particle is moving clockwise. This arrow mark is given, so it is moving clockwise. Now if it is moving clockwise and at time t is equal to 0 it is here, after t seconds say the particle is here. Let me write position vector. Now see the angle from here to here. See, the particle is moving with omega angular speed, therefore the angle will be omega t. This angle is π/2 and this angle is omega t. So the net angle, now the angle from x-axis is this π/2 minus omega t. So this position vector is making an angle π/2 minus omega t. So this angle is noted. Now we have to draw a triangle. See, let us draw perpendicular onto the x-axis. This will be the projection point. And we got the right angled triangle OPN. So this angle is π/2 minus omega t. Now this is x of t. this is x of t. So now we want this only. We want this. So cos pi by 2 minus omega t is equal to adjacent side by hypotenuse. Adjacent side is x of t. Hypotenuse is radius of the circle, and here the radius of circle is given as b, capital B. So by cross multiplying we have b cos pi by 2 minus omega t. But now omega. But omega is equal to 2 pi by capital T. 2 pi by capital T. Capital T time period is given. Time period is 30 seconds. So now substituting this in this equation, x of t is equal to b cos pi by 2 minus 2 pi by 30 into t. If you want the omega t here, take minus common. We can write like this. Suppose this is treated as theta. In trigonometry we have a relation. Cos of minus theta is equal to cos theta. Therefore, you can write this as x of t is equal to b cos 2 pi by 30 t minus pi by 2. So this is the answer. There is a short answer question 7th. Derive the expressions for displacement, velocity and acceleration of a particle executing simple harmonic motion. Let us consider this. A particle is under uniform circular motion, then its projection point on x-axis will execute simple harmonic motion on x-axis about origin. Now we are concerned about the projection point, because this projection point will execute simple harmonic motion. At a time, see, initially the particle was here, making an angle. The angle made by the particle at t is equal to 0 is called initial phase. Say the initial phase is pi. And in t seconds, the particle moved from here to here, making an angle omega t. So now at time t, the particle is making an angle omega t plus pi with x-axis. And its projection on x-axis is at n, and its distance from origin is given as x of t, and this gives you the displacement. If we consider this right angle triangle, see here the angle is omega t plus pi, so let us write cos omega t plus pi, that is equal to adjacent side by hypotenuse. Adjacent side is on, and hypotenuse is op. See, OP is nothing but radius of the circle. Radius of the circle is A. Radius of the circle is A. Now, ON is displacement. OP is radius of the circle, that is A. Now, by cross multiplying, we get so this is the expression for displacement. This is the expression for displacement. So, first one over. We got expression for displacement. Now, second, velocity. Velocity. How we define velocity? Rate of change of displacement is called velocity. So velocity at time t will be defined as dx by dt. That means by differentiating this, we get velocity. A is a constant, we write outside. By differentiating cosine function, we get minus sine. Now, by differentiating omega t, see t is a variable. When you differentiate t with respect to t, you get 1. So, omega t becomes omega. Plus, this initial phase is a constant, and if you differentiate a constant, you get 0. So now we can write omega writing here and minus here, minus a omega sine omega t plus pi. So in this way, we found expression for velocity also. But here we can do one more thing. See, suppose this is equation 1. 1 is equation for displacement, and this is equation for velocity. So this is 2a. Now you can process this equation. How means? We all know that cos pi by 2 plus theta is equal to, see, pi by 2 plus means it comes under second quadrant. In the second quadrant, cos is minus. So therefore, we write this as minus sin theta. So, in our equation, you are having minus sin theta. So, this minus sin theta can be replaced with cos pi by 2 plus theta. Therefore, we can write this as a omega cos pi by 2 plus theta means this angle. So you can write in this way also. You can write in this way also. Let me round up this trigonometric relation. Okay. Now you may ask, why write this in this manner? So now you can compare phase angles of displacement and velocity. For displacement, the phase angle is omega t plus pi, and for velocity, the phase angle is, in addition to that, you are having plus pi by 2. Now, what is the phase difference between velocity and displacement? So, this minus this gives you pi by 2. So it means velocity is pi by 2 radians ahead of the displacement. So like this, to compare phases, this form of equation helps. Okay, now let us go back to our old form. And one more thing here is the sine. See, we have another trigonometric relation, that is sine square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1. Or cascaded. So now here in place of this 2a we are having sine theta. This sine theta can be expressed in this form. So let us write this 2a equation as, let me write here, vt is equal to minus a omega in place of sine omega t plus, we have to write like this, under root 1 minus cos square omega t plus pi. So in this way we can write. Now let us move this a inside the root. Here a and here it becomes a square. So multiplying this by a square minus a square cos square omega t plus pi, and here minus omega a square minus a cos omega t plus pi square is equal to minus omega a square minus. See, a cos omega t plus pi is displacement here. You can see here a cos omega t plus pi is displacement of the projection point at time t. So in place of this, let us write x square. So now we got expression for velocity in another manner, and this form is used while solving the problems, and this can be taken as (2c). Right, now the remaining is acceleration. The rate of change of velocity is called acceleration. Therefore, to find expression for acceleration, we differentiate velocity function. Let us take this 2a form. A and omega are constants. When you differentiate sine function, you get cosine function. It When you differentiate omega, you get omega, and this becomes 0. So that you can write omega into omega omega square minus a omega square cos omega t plus pi. But here, let me write minus omega square first and write a afterwards. See, a cos omega t plus pi is nothing but xt. So, in place of this, you can write x. xt. So, this is one equation for acceleration. Now, to understand the phase relations, this minus should not be there. For that, we can do one thing. There is a trigonometric relation cos pi minus theta is equal to minus cos theta. Y minus means cos pi minus theta means it comes under second quadrant, and in the second quadrant cosine function is negative. Therefore, in place of minus cos theta, you can write cos pi minus theta here. So, substituting this here, a of t is equal to omega square, let me write a first, afterwards omega square, and cos pi minus so minus cos theta is written as cos pi by pi minus theta. Minus cos theta is written as cos pi minus theta. Okay. Now, let us look at the expression for displacement. Here, x is equal to a cos omega t plus pi. Here, cos pi minus omega t plus pi. So, what is the difference? What is the phase difference? There is a phase difference between this and this. So, you can easily compare. Similarly, you can compare with velocity expression also. Where is the velocity expression? Here. Here this is pi by 2 plus omega t plus pi. And here pi minus omega t plus pi. So, you can calculate the phase difference. So, as per phase, which is ahead of which, that can be found. So, that can be considered as a separate topic. So, here, now, if this is taken as 3a, this becomes 3b, and this becomes 3c. In this way, acceleration also expressed in three different forms. This 3b form is more useful in solving the problems. We write this simply as a is equal to minus omega square x. So here, if the displacement is along x-axis, if the displacement is along y-axis, we write a is equal to minus omega square y. Like that. And one more thing here, see, omega is a constant. Therefore, from this we get an interesting result, and that is A is directly proportional to minus x. That is, acceleration is directly proportional to displacement. This minus sign tells you that, see, displacement is a vector, acceleration is a vector. Therefore, the minus sign tells you that these two are oppositely directed. If displacement is to right hand side, acceleration is to left hand side. So in this way, so this can be discussed in detail in next topic. Now, as far as our short answer question 7 is concerned, we are asked to obtain expressions for displacement, velocity and acceleration. That's all. See, there is a question, short answer question 3rd one. What is phase? Discuss phase relations between displacement, velocity and acceleration. First, what is phase? We already know phase means phase angle. Here, the particle is moving on a circle. At time t is equal to 0, the particle is here. And the position vector connecting the particle is making some angle with positive x-axis. And this angle at t is equal to 0 is called initial phase. Initial phase. And after t seconds, the particle moved from here to here. Now, the phase angle is, see, this is nothing but phase at t is equal to 0. This is phase at t is equal to 0. Now, phase at t is equal to t, and that is called phase. And that is equal to pi plus omega t. So omega t plus pi. So in this way, what is phase? Phase is an angle, and that angle tells you where is the particle on the circuit. Where is the particle on the circuit? Okay, so the particle at time t is here. Now what you do, you draw a projection onto x-axis. The projection point is n. As the particle is moving round and round on the circle, the projection point n will making simple harmonic motion on x-axis. Now we are concerned about simple harmonic motion. Okay, at time t, where is the projection point? Here. So here means from origin it is at a distance of xt. Now if you know the phase angle, you can tell what is the displacement, whether it is to right hand side of the origin or whether it is to left side of the origin. See, like that we can understand the simple harmonic motion. Now for that, let us draw a graph here. See, at time t is equal to 0, already it is having some phase angle. See, suppose this is some 30 degrees like that. Here 90 degrees, 180, 270, 360. So 30 degrees means somewhere here. So here, at this angle, zero means when the phase angle is 0, the particle will be here and the projection point also here, ON. So this is the ON means A value. So here plus a, this is minus a. So when the phase angle is zero, the projection point is here and the displacement is becoming equal to a. Okay, one point is located corresponding to zero phase angle. When the phase angle is 90 degrees, when the phase angle is 90 degrees here, now the projection point comes here. The projection point is coinciding with the origin, it means displacement is zero. At pi by 2 phase angle, displacement is zero. So on x axis, y axis, you have taken displacement, it is zero. And now when the particle came here, it is here, the angle is here to here pi radians, and the projection point will be here, and the displacement is minus a. Here plus a, here minus a. So here minus a. And when the particle moves from here to here, 90 plus 90 plus 90, 270 or 3 pi by 2. Now again the projection point coincides with O, origin. Displacement is zero. And when the particle comes to here, the projection point will be here and the displacement will be maximum. The displacement is and in plus a. Now you can draw a graph like this. Based on the phase angle, you can tell. Suppose you arbitrarily you choose one angle. Suppose here, at this particular angle, you draw like corresponding to this angle. This is the displacement, and the displacement is on positive side. Here to on right hand side. So at this angle, our the projection point is on right hand side. The displacement is positive, and so this much displacement is there. If you choose an angle here arbitrarily, then you draw a perpendicular like this. Corresponding to this, the displacement is here. So at this phase angle, see, the projection point is making simple harmonic motion and it is at a distance of so and so on left hand side of the origin. So like this, if you know the phase, you can speak about displacement of the simple harmonic motion. So that is the importance of the phase. Now, what is the next part? Discuss phase relations between displacement, velocity and acceleration. Previously, we derived expressions for displacement, velocity and acceleration. Now, if you consider the phase, let us consider phase relations. See, phase difference between velocity and displacement. See, whatever is there beside the cosine function, that is phase. So here this is the phase and here this is the phase. So phase difference between velocity and displacement. So this minus this, that is equal to pi by 2. It means our, as far as phase is concerned, our velocity is leading by the displacement. It is ahead of the displacement by this much. Like that we interpret. Now, Let us compare acceleration is phase with respect to displacement. So here this is pi minus something, and here pi this. So here the difference is pi. Here the difference is pi. See, now here, suppose this also can be written as omega t plus pi minus pi. In this way also you can write, because cos minus theta is equal to cos theta. Therefore, this can be written in this way also. Now you compare, you can better compare here. Here, compared to this, here it is lagging by some angle, pi radians. So acceleration lags compared to displacement. Our acceleration lags behind displacement by how much angle? Pi radians. So in this way, we discuss phase relations.